Hello, everyone. You are live with Caitlin from Banker Inc. Today, we are going to be reviewing how to enter an AP invoice from scratch in Sage 100 Contractor. So first, we're going to open up our company. Today, just like every other day, we're going to be operating in the sample company. So we'll open that up, and then we will navigate on the left-hand menu to Accounts Payable. From there, we're going to drop down to the second option for Payable Invoices and Credits. From there, you're going to get a pop-up, just like a vendor screen or an employee screen, with some of the same columns and data entry fields. So this invoice number is going to be a required field. So anything with an asterisk next to it is going to be required in order to save this entry. Our big suggestion is that on the invoice, tracking this number by putting the invoice number that is on there. Whatever numbering scheme that makes for you guys, if that looks super crazy, that would be the best way so it's easily traceable. Order number and subcontract number are optional, but if your company utilizes these methods, it would be very beneficial to put an entry in there. So maybe that is this one, and that pre-populates on the order number with the vendor and job. From here, if you guys use phase on your bids or on your jobs, insert that as well. This job does not have any phases, and so I'm going to leave that one blank. So we'll enter a description as it's a required field, and then we're going to insert the invoice date. If you click this drop down arrow, it's going to pre-populate a calendar for you. And so that will already put in the due date for you based on that invoice. On this status, we're going to put open unless we are ready to review or dispute it. And then we'll leave pay alone since for this demonstration, we are just entering it. The type is also a required field, and there's two different categories, contract and memo. Contract is if this is related to a job and you are needing to job cost for it. Memo is just something that you are paying an invoice for. So two different methods, but very critical in how you want to track this and how you want to see it pop up on the other end of outside of payables. Here we have some optional fields as well. Using the tax district, most companies do not utilize this field, but it's still an option. Or if you want to track work comp codes and rates, that would be the box to do that in. From here, you can save this record. There we go. Make sure all of these are filled out in here. So account number will need to be filled in. There we go. And from there, when we put that contract in there for that type one, we'll need to put a work norm. It'll pop up with our job costs. Make sure it's going to the right job and how much the amount is going to be on our ledger and our job cost total. Once we hit save on the job costs, the payable invoice will save as well. That's a good sign that it's gone to that job for it to be job costed accordingly. So there we have it. If we did just put it as a memo, it would not pop up with that secondary screen for the job cost because that is just for a payable invoice to be paid, oftentimes just a one-time payable or something that's not tied to a direct job. Perfect. If that helps anybody, I'm super grateful. But if there's any other questions that I can help with, please feel free to reach out. Email us at coordinator@bankerinc.com and we will help you guys out as best as we can. Thank you guys.